Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. With the release of Flame 2020, a whole range of new technology has been integrated into the Flame products. This is in the form of machine learning, which uses trained artificial intelligence to analyze an image and compute a variety of data that you could use for VFX and look development. So you could use this data to isolate a part of your image when grading through a 3D selective or further enhance a 2D or 3D composite when working in action. There are quite a variety of use cases, and we'll cover quite a few as more videos are added to the machine learning series. In part 1, you'll be introduced to the Z-depth generator when working in a sequence within the effects environment. As a side note, this machine learning is also available in Batch and BatchFX. You'll find it as a Matchbox node, within the Image node, as well as within the Action 3D Compositor. These topics will also be covered in later videos. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the description below to download the zip file. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Now let's use the shot to set the context. Here you have a character that is clearly feeling unwell, and you'd like to visually emphasize this even further through look development. So ensure the shot is selected and switch to the effects environment. I also suggest using the manager to see and interact with the various components of the image toolset. Press Alt-2 for a 2-up view, and press 8 to display the manager. Now if you scrub the time bar, this shot is tracking forwards towards the main character. In order to make him look even further sad or ill, he needs to be isolated from the background with a selective and then graded accordingly. In previous versions of the Flame products, you would choose a selective and then either key the subject or mask it out or even use a combination of both tools. But now you can also use 3D data via the 3D AOVs in the selective controls. The only problem is that this is a live action shot. And unless you are able to capture the depth information on location, you might consider the 3D selectives unusable in this context. So this is where the machine learning Z-depth generator can be very useful. You could select the surface in the manager and apply a depth map using the contextual menu. However, a much easier way is with your chosen selective, you just click Create Map in the selective's 3D AOV menu. It takes a small amount of time to analyze the image, and a Z-depth map is added to the surface object. Now let's take a quick peek at what the Z-depth map is actually doing. If you select and look at the Z-depth controls, the Z-depth map is set to global analysis. This means Flame is looking at the entire shot and is attempting to understand and calculate the depth within the shot. You can see this if you press F8 to display the selected Z-depth map in the object viewer. Now there are also some alternative options when it comes to a Z-depth map. For example, when you click the pull-down menu, you have face analysis and media input. Face analysis recognizes a human face and then calculates the depth of the facial features when working together with a normals map to relight facial features. You'll look at that in a later video. And finally, the media input setting expects an external input. So if you're working on CGI and you rendered a Z-depth pass, you could use this setting in Batch with either an image node or action node. So those are your three choices. But for this type of example, you'll stick with global analysis. Now this Z-depth is a 32-bit data pass that has been generated through machine learning. In other words, during Flame's development, the application was exposed to a whole range of different scenarios and now has the ability to determine relative depth between objects. This is all based on what the machine learning has analyzed up to the release of Flame 2020. This is by no means perfect, but as the machine learning continues to evolve with Flame's development, it should hopefully be more successful with its outcomes in the future. This functionality is rarely shot-dependent, and please bear in mind that it does not extract fine details in depth. It's still worth giving you the Z-Depth generator a go on all your shots, but here is a slide considering some of the shots where the depth analysis may struggle. Normally, there are certain factors which may make it difficult to compute the depth of a shot. For example, a landscape or a shot with a very bright or overblown sky. Any shots with heavy motion blur make it indistinguishable to determine the shot depth. Night shots are possible candidates for depth generation, as long as the lighting and flaring are not too overwhelming and under control. Obviously, if an area is very dark, you won't get any depth perception either. Finally, exaggerated shots, like extreme close-ups, low or high angles, or anything that is overtly unnatural with the composition of the shot, will make it difficult to determine the background, and therefore the depth analysis will struggle. This may change in later versions of Flame as the machine learning gets smarter. Secondly, depending on your system performance, it is possible to cache the Z-depth analysis, but this is not a mandatory requirement. Coming back to our example, let's use the Z-depth generation with the 3D selectives. Switch the viewer to the result view with F4 and choose and expand the selective in the manager. If you start grading with the master grade, the entire image is being affected. So I've desaturated the image and made some other adjustments to make him look very bleak. So the entire shot looks different and not just the main character. To use the depth map in order to segment the image, switch to the 3D AOV menu. Currently, the type is set to distance. When you increase the amount, this activates the 3D selective, and you can see that the grade is affecting the shot based on the depth map. To make this very clear, press F8 to see the selective matte object view. Adjusting the amount now, you can see how the Z-depth is being used to calculate the isolation for the selective. All the different falloff types are also available through the pull-down menu. If you switch the selective type to near-far, you can adjust the values to isolate the image segmentation by manually defining your near and far planes. Range is another option using Z-depth, but that will be covered in the 3D selective videos. If you hover over the viewer and switch to the result view with F4, you can see how the selective has isolated the character from the background. Now the edges of the selective look a little bit harsh, and this is to be expected when working with a Z-depth pass. All Z-depth passes are binary data, and this means they don't contain semi-transparencies, etc. However, through the selective post-processing, you can blur the isolation even if it is created from the Z-depth analysis. You can see this if you toggle between the result and the selective matte object viewer. If you scrub the sequence, it looks pretty good, but the juice carton is half included in the selective isolation. You only want the character affected and nothing else. So even though you're using a 3D selective to segment the image, you can also combine it with a G-mask to add or remove sections in the selective. Call up the contextual menu over the selective and add a rectangular G-mask. Draw it over the juice carton, and that will isolate the Z-depth within the G-mask. To affect the outside of the G-mask instead, switch to the controls menu and choose to invert the G-mask. So the workflow is the same as before when combining keyers, masks, and 3D data within the selectives. Select the mask and perform a planar track to match the movement of the image. Now, to conclude this example, you can use the same Z-depth analysis on multiple selectives. For example, add another selective to the surface without the master grade. In the file browser, scroll the list and choose the bloom selective effects. Decreasing the threshold blooms the darker parts of the whole image. To limit this to just the background, switch to the 3D AOV menu and start increasing the distance type linear amount to about 3. This is currently affecting the foreground instead of the background. So invert the rendering and blur the isolation to around 50%. You can now adjust the bloom threshold to taste. Secondly, change the bloom color to make it look a little sunnier outside. Finally, select the output master grade and warm the overall result towards red. Now, hopefully this has whet your appetite to try out machine learning in the Flame 2020 products. This video has only shown the Z-depth generator within the effects environment, but it is also available in Batch and BatchFX, which can lead on to other use cases. In the next video, you'll learn about another machine learning analysis that is specifically designed for recognizing human faces and generating normal maps. This can be used for enhancing and relighting parts of the human face. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.